Conversely, people react poorly to losing video games. They can break their controllers or yell at what is known as rage quitting. It could also cause other anger issues and short tempers. Aside from this, playing video games can result in short attention span, causing kids to read less and fall behind on schoolwork. Gaming can also cause inappropriate behavior, headaches, eye strain, obesity,
and
anxiety, along with other physiological problems. Excessive gaming can have a significant negative impact on your relationship with education, career, and sleep. The other side may argue that it could benefit you socially. However, the negative health outweighs the pros. It's clear that the popularity of video games has blinded most kids.
All kids have heard this worldwide saying, video games can turn your brain to mush. However, this statement made by parents is not true. In fact, video games have many benefits to both mental and physical health. For your mental health, video games help you reduce stress through a calming outlet. For your physical health, there are numerous benefits, including improved hand and eye coordination. In fact, many people with hand disabilities use video games to improve their movement. Certain video games can also help with math or ELA skills, helping you prepare for school and exams in an engaging way. The other side may claim that video games cause anxiety, but they actually calm you down and eliminate stress, providing a fun way to relax yourself. It is clear video games are good because they help you with your hand-eye coordination, reduces stress, and can help you learn.
When looking at the physical effects, according to Dr. Moberg, when video games can cause weakness and numbness in the hands, and even blood clots, skin blisters, and wrist, neck, and elbow pain. Much research has been done to show that video games impact your brain's ability to change in response to learning through its use of attention control and reward process. According to Lau and Yi, these data suggest very strongly that participating in playing of the violent video games by children and youth increases aggressive thoughts and behavior, increases antisocial behavior and delinquency, and decreases school performance.
Firstly, kids who played math-related video games improved their math grades by 32% compared to those who did not. There are also specific games to raise your IQ. Additionally, studies show kids who spent above average playing video games saw a 2.5 increased IQ than those who didn't. Aside from the physical benefits, there are numerous mental benefits. For example, veterans have used mental benefits to cope with post-traumatic stress disorder, commonly known as PTSD. In people who are 60 to 80 years old, those who played a memory game had experienced improved long-term memory demonstrating another benefit. Playing video games also helps you to socialize. For example, it helps you make friends and allows you to enjoy time with your buddies. There are all these great benefits to playing video games, so does it really make sense to ban it? The economic impact of banning video games will be bad because the people that bought video game stuff will have wasted their money on them. Other companies that sell and create video games would lose their money and job loss will occur.
While the other side may argue that video games help kids spend time with their friends, in reality, video games give students a platform for online bullying. The unsupervised platform creates a negative environment full of racism, hate speech, and sexism. There is a high chance of kids/teens getting addicted due to dopamine, the reward system in your mind that makes you happy. You will feel happy, but all the time you will get addicted. Video game addiction is a real disorder and affects many teenagers and young children. This disorder can have several development effects, especially on a young child. Bouts of depression, social anxiety, mood swings, and loss of interest in other activities are all signs that your child may have a gaming addiction. Sometimes, when you are gaming, you can also get scammed since other people get hacked. In some games, there are also inappropriate people, and the games themselves are sometimes inappropriate too. Games can cause dehydration, obesity, and heart problems.
May claim that video games bring families apart, but family gaming time can help bond kids with their parents. Studies have shown that the more frequently family members play video games together, the better family satisfaction and family closeness they have. It also can encourage teamwork and critical thinking through parents and children working together. Additionally, the other side may claim that video games lead to cyberbullying, but video games allow for communication where people can build friendships and meaningful relationships. In fact, studies show that when played in moderation, gaming can serve as a building block for friendships, creating bonds across continents and teaching children and adults important social, cognitive, and emotional skills.
Now we hope you can see that how video games should be banned. They can show inappropriate things that children should not see. It can also cause health problems like headaches, eye problems, and dehydration. Some people get hacked and banned from the games that they enjoy, and they can get scammed for their money too. Children can also get bullied, which could affect how they behave in their present and future behavior. Too much video games can cause
video games should not be banned because children love them, and they have many health benefits. Video games are a part of our everyday lives. They are used to communicate with friends, to learn new things, and to improve our mental health, and allow us to bond with our families. Improve. While obsessive gaming can be negative, using video games in moderation allows for all of these benefits. Some may see video games as a waste of time and think they are not good for you. But in reality, gaming is a large part of our society for both children and adults.